Okay, take her up and over the bow rail. Okay, we're going over the bow. Stay with us. Okay, quiet, we're rolling. Seeing her come out of the darkness like a ghost ship still gets me every time to see the sad ruin of the great ship sitting here where she landed at 2:30 in the morning of April 15th, 1912. After her long fall from the world above, you are so full of poop, boss. Dive 6, here we are again on the deck of Titanic. The pressure outside is these windows are 9 inches thick. And if they go, it's sayonara in 2 microseconds. Alright, enough of that bull poop. Just put it on the down. On the rooftop, the officer's quarters like yesterday. Sure, okay. We have landed right on the grand staircase. You guys set to launch. Yeah, Brock. Launching Duncan now. I'll go, Charlie. All right, tether out. Tether out. Okay, Brock. Oh, we're dropping down along the hole. Oh, roger that. Okay, drop down and go into the first class gangway door. I want you two working on the D-deck reception area and the dining saloon. Copy that. Tether out. Tether out. Now left, left, I'm coming left. Snoop Dogg on the move. We're headed down the stairwell. Okay, Lewis, drop down to B deck, a deck. Give me some rope, Captain. B deck, get in there. Get in there, watch the door frame. Watch the door frame, I see it. I got it. We're good, just chill, boss. Make your turn, come around. Cable out, Captain. Make your turn, watch the wall. Yeah, Brock, we're at the piano. You copy. Okay, copy that. Okay, right there, right there. That's it. That's the bedroom door. I see it in. We're in, baby, we're there. That's Hockley's bed. That's where that son of a bleep slept. Oops, somebody left the water running. Hey, hold it just a second. Go back to the right. That wardrobe door. Get closer. You smelling something, boss? I want to see what's under it. Give me my hands, man. All right. Take it easy. It might come apart. Okay. Go, 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 go. Flip it over. Flip it over. Go, keep going, go. Go, go, okay, drop it, okay, baby, baby. Are you seeing this, boss? It's payday, boys. Ka-ching. We did it, Bobby. Oh, yeah, who's the man? Who's the best, baby? Say it, you are Lewis. Bobby, my cigar, Bobby, right here. Okay, crack her open. Poop, no diamond. You know, boss, this same thing happened to Geraldo. And his career never recovered. Turn the camera off. Brock, the partners would like to know how it's going. Hey, Dave. Very high. Look, it wasn't in the safe, but hey, hey. Don't worry about it. There's still plenty of places it could be. Heck yes. Floor debris in the suit. The mother's room purses. Safe on the C deck. Jimmy Hoffa's briefcase. A dozen other places. Guys, look, you've just got to trust my instincts. I know we're close. We just gotta go through a little process of elimination. Hang on a second. Let me see that. We have something here, guys. Where's the photograph of the necklace? We'll call you right back. I'll be gosh darn. Treasure hunter. Brock Lovett is best known for finding Spanish gold. It's okay. I'll feed you in a minute. Now he has chartered Russian subs to reach the most famous shipwreck of all, the Titanic. He is with us live via satellite from the research ship Keldysh in North Atlantic. Hello, Brock. Hello, Tracy. Everyone knows the familiar stories of Titanic, the nobility, the band playing till the very end of, and all that. But what I'm interested in are the untold stories, the secrets locked deep inside the hull of Titanic. We're out here using robot technology to go further into the wreck than anyone's ever done before. You expedition is at the center of a storm of controversy over salvage rights and even ethics. Many people are calling you a grave robber. Nobody's called the recovery of artifacts of King Tut's tomb grave robbing. What is it? Turn that up, dear. I have museum-trained experts out here making sure that these relics are preserved and cataloged properly. And take a look at this drawing that we found just today. A piece of paper that's been underwater for 84 years. And my team were able to preserve it intact, should this have remained unseen at the bottom of the ocean for eternity. I'll be gosh darned. Brock, there's a satellite call for you, Bobby. We're launching. You see these submerlises going to the water? Trust me, buddy, you want to take this call. This better be good. You gotta speak up. She's kind of old. Great this, Brock Lovett. How can I help you, Miss Calvert? Rose Calvert, Miss Calvert. I was just wondering if you had found the heart of the ocean yet, Mr. Lovett. Had told you you wanted to take the call. All right, you have my attention, Rose. Can you tell us who the woman in the picture is? Oh yes, the woman in the picture is me. She's a gosh darn liar, some nutcase seeking money or publicity. God only knows why. Like that Russian babe, anesthesia, they're inbound. Rose DeWitt, but Bakuda died on the Titanic when she was 17, right? That's right. If she had lived, she'd be over 100. Okay, so she's a very old gosh darn liar. Look, I've already done the background on this woman all the way back to the 20s. She was a working actress. An actress. There's your first clue, Sherlock. Her name was Rose Dawson back then. Then she marries this guy named Calvert. They move to Cedar Rapids. Then she punches out a couple of kids. Now Calvert's dead, and from what I hear, Cedar Rapids is dead, and everybody who knows about the diamond is supposed to be dead or on this boat. But she knows, doesn't exactly travel light, does she? Miss Calvert, I'm Mick Brock Lovett. Welcome to the Keldysh. Okay, let's get her. Inside there. Hi, Miss Calvert. Hi. Welcome to the Keldysh. Hey, hey. Yes. Are your staterooms all right? Oh, yes. Very nice. Have you met my granddaughter, Lizzie? She takes care of me. We met just a few minutes ago, remember, Nana? Up on the deck, that's there, that's very nice. Have to have my pictures when I travel. Can I get you anything? Is there anything you'd like? Yes, I would like to see my drawing. Louis, the something thwart famous stone that was called the Blue Diamond of the Crown, which disappeared in 1792. About the same time, old Louis lost everything from the neck up. The theory goes that the crown diamond was chopped to recut into a heart-like shape that became known as Heart of the Ocean. Today it would be worth more. Then the Hope Diamond. It was dreadful. Heavy thing, I only wore it this once. You actually think this is you, Nana? It was me, dear. Wasn't I a dish? I tracked it down through insurance records, an old claim that was settled under terms of absolute secrecy. Can you tell me who the claimant was, Rose? I should imagine someone named Hockley, Nathan Hockley, that's right, Pittsburgh. Steel tycoon claim was for a diamond necklace his son Caledon bought his fiance you a week before he sailed on Titanic. It was filled right after the sinking, so the diamond had have to gone down with the ship. You see the date, April 14th, 1912, which means if your grandmother is who she says she is, she was wearing the diamond the day Titanic sank, and that makes you my new best friend. These are some of the other things we recovered from your stateroom. This was mine. How extraordinary. And it looks just the same as it did the last time I saw it. The reflection has changed a bit. Are you ready to go back to Titanic? Okay, here we go. Oh, she hits the berg on the starboard side, right? She kind of bumps along the punching holes like Morse code. Dit, dit, dit along the side below the water line. Then the forward compartment starts to flood. Now, as the water level rises, it spills over the watertight bulkheads, which unfortunately doesn't go any higher than E deck. So now, as the bow goes down, the stern rises up, slow at first, then faster and faster, until finally she's got her hole sticking up in the air, and that's a big butt we're talking, and the hole's not designed to deal with the pressure. So what happens? She splits right down to the keel, and the stern falls back level, and then as the boat sinks, it pulls the stern vertically and finally detaches. Now the stern section just kind of bobs there like a cork for a couple of minutes, floods and finally goes under. About 2:20 a.m., 2 hours and 40 minutes after the collision, the bow section planes away, landing about a half a mile away. Going 20, 30 knots when it hits the ocean floor. Pretty cool, huh? Thank you for that forensic analysis, Mr. Bodine. Of course, the experience of it was somewhat different. Will you share it with us? I'm taking here to rest. No, come on, Nana. No tape recorder. Tell us, Rose. It's been 84 years. It's okay. Just try to remember. Anything. Anything at all. Do you want to hear this? Or not, Mr. Lovett? It's been 84 years and I could still smell the fresh paint. The china had never been used. The sheets had never been slept in. Titanic was called the Ship of Dreams, and it really was all third-class passengers with a forward berth. This way, please, this queue. Right here, big boat, huh, Daddy? It's a ship. You're right. I don't see what all the fuss is about. It doesn't look any bigger than the Mauritanata. You can be blessed about some things, Rose, but not about Titanic. It's about over 100 feet longer than Mauritania and far more luxurious. Your daughter is far too difficult to impress, Ruth. So this is the ship they say is unsinkable. It is unsinkable. God himself could not sink this ship. Sir, you have to check your baggage through the main terminal. It's round this way, sir. I put my faith in you, good sir. Now kindly see my man. Yes, sir. My pleasure, sir. If I can do anything at all, yes, right. All the trunks from that cart there to the parlor suite. Rooms B52, 54, 56. Ladies, better hurry. My coat. Woman, I have it. All third-class passengers due here for a health inspection. All third-class passengers due here for health inspection. Heads up. Welcome aboard, ma'am. Welcome to Titanic. It was the ship of dreams. To everyone else, to me, it was a slave ship, taking me back to America in chains. Outwardly, I was everything a well-brought-up girl should be. Inside, I was screaming, Jack, you are the paso. You bet everything we have when you got nothing. Well, you got nothing to lose, Sven. All right, moment of truth. Somebody's life's about to change. Fabrizio, niente, niente, hola, nothing, Sven. Uh-oh, two pair. I'm sorry, Fabrizio. Cesare, ma falacunci, you bet all the money. I'm sorry, you're not going to see your mom again for a long time. Because we're going to America, full house, boys. Woo, yeah. Dio mio grazie. Come on. Figelio, Dio Pontu, I'm going home. I'm going home. I go to America. No, mate. Titanic. Go to America. In 5 minutes. Come on, come on. Here, Edin Emmanuel. We're riding in high style now. We're a couple of regular swells. We're practically gosh darn royalty. Regreso mio. You see, it's my destiny. Oh, like I told you to go to America to be millionaire. Whoa, whoa. Do I start your puzzle? Maybe I've got the tickets. Come on, I thought you were fast. Aspetta, wait, wait. Hey, wait, we're passengers. Passengers, have you been through the inspection queue, of course. We don't have any lice. We're Americans, both of us, right? Come aboard. We're the luckiest sons of Philips in the world, you know that. Goodbye. You know somebody. Of course not, that's not the point. Goodbye, I'll miss you. Goodbye. I'm going to never forget you. All the way, darling, excuse me, ma'am. Oh, right here. How you doing? Nice to meet you. I'm Jack Dawson. Nice to meet you. How you doing? Who says you can get to the top bunk? This is your private promenade deck, sir. Would you be requiring anything? Excuse me. This one note has lots of faces on it. This is the one. Would you like all of them, miss? Yes, we need a little color in this room. Put it in there in the boardroom. No, gosh, no, I don't want those finger paintings again. They certainly were a waste of money. The difference between cow's taste in art and mine is that I have some. They're fascinating, like something inside of a dream or something. There's truth, but no logic. What's the artist's name? Something Picasso, something Picasso. He won't amount to a thing. He won't trust me. Put the dagus in the bedroom. At least they were cheap. Put the in the wardrobe. Sure, bug a woman came. The board name, Margaret Brown. And we all call her Molly. History would later call her the unsinkable Molly Brown. Well, I wasn't about to wait all day for you. Sonny, here you think you can manage. Her husband had struggled someplace out west, and she was what mother called new money. By the next afternoon, we were steaming west from the coast of Fireland, and with nothing but out ahead of us but ocean. Take care to see Mr. Morduck. Let's stretch our legs. Yes, sir, all ahead full. Mr. Moody, very good, sir. All ahead full, all ahead full. Come on, lads, get moving. What's the reading? All right, let's stoke them up. We're going full ahead. Hey, look, 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 see it? There's another one. See him? Look at that one. Look at him jump. Woo-hoo-hoo, woo, I can see the Statue of Liberty already, very small, of course. I'm king of the world. She's the largest moving object ever made by the hand of man in all of history. And our master shipbuilder, Mr. Andrews here, designed her from the keel plates up. Well, I may have knocked her together, but the idea was Mr. Ismay's. He envisioned a steamer so grand in scale and so luxurious in its appointments that its supremacy would never be challenged. And here she is, wheeled into solid reality. Here, here. You know I don't like that rose. She knows. We both have the lamb rare with... very little mint sauce. You like lamb, right, sweet pea? Are you going to cut her meat for her too there, Cal? Hey, who thought of the name Titanic? Was it you, Bruce? Well, yes, actually. I want to convey sheer size, and the size I mean stability, luxury, and above all, strength. Do you know of Dr. Freud, Mr. Ismay, his ideas about the male preoccupation with size might be a particular interest to you? What's gone into you? Excuse me. I do apologize. She's a pistol cow. I hope you can handle her. Well, I may have to start minding what she reads from now on, won't I, Mrs. Brown? Freud, who is he? Is he a passenger? It makes these waves, makes them spin. Their ship is nice, huh? Yeah, it's an Irish ship. Is English? No. No, it was built in Ireland. Solid as rock. Big Irish chance. That's typical. First class dogs, come here to take a poop. Let us know where we rank in the scheme of things, like we could forget. I'm Tommy Ryan, Jack Dawson, hello. Fabrizio, hi. Do you make any money with your drawings? Oh, forget it, boyo. You'd as like have angels fly out of your arm. But as get next to the likes of her. Do you mind? I hope you're proud of this. Is my whole life's as if I've lived it. An endless parade of parties and cuddlings. Yachts and polo matches. Always the same narrow people. The same mindlessness chatter. I felt like was standing a great praise piece with no one to pull me back. No one who cared or even noticed. Don't do it. Stay back. Don't come any closer. Come on, just give me your hand. I'll pull you back over. No, stay where you are. I mean it. I'll let you go. Don't. You won't. What do you mean? No, I won't. Don't presume to tell me what I will and will not do. You don't know me. Well, you would have done it already. You're distracting me. Go away. I can't. I'm involved now. You let go and I'm going to have to jump in there after you. Don't be absurd, you'll be killed. I'm a good swimmer. To fall alone would kill you, it would hurt. I'm not saying it wouldn't. To tell you the truth, I'm a lot more concerned about the water being so cold. How cold? Freezing. Maybe a couple degrees over. You ever been to Wisconsin? What? Well, they have some of the coldest winters around. I grew up there near Chippewa Falls. I remember when I was a kid. Me and my father, we went ice fishing out on Lake Wissoda. Ice fishing is, you know, where are you? I know what ice fishing is. Sorry, you just seem like, you know, a kinda indoor girl. Anyway, I fell through the thin ice. And I'm telling you, water that cold, like right down there, it hits you like a thousand knives, stabbing you all over your body. You can't breathe, you can't think, at least not about anything but the pain, which is why I'm not looking forward to jumping in there after you. Like I said, I don't have a choice. I guess I'm kinda hoping you'll come back over the rail and get me off the hook here. That, you're crazy. That's what everybody says, but with all due respect, miss, I'm not the one hanging off the back of a ship here. Come on. Come on, give me your hand. You don't wanna do this, woo. I'm Jack Dawson, Rose DeWitt, Buck Attar. I'm going to have to get you to write that one down. Come on. I got you. Come on, come on. Help, please. Help, please, please get me. Hey, listen, listen to me. I've got you. I won't let go. Now pull yourself up. Come on. Come on, that's right. You can do it. I got you. What's all this? You stand back and don't move an inch. Fetch the master at arms. Care for a brandy? This is completely unacceptable. What made you think that you could put your hands on my fiance? Look at me, you filth. Cal, what do you think you were doing? Cal, stop. It was an accident. An accident? Was it stupid, really? I was leaning over and I slipped. I was leaning far over to see the propellers, and I slipped, but and I would have gone overboard. But Mr. Dawson here saved me and almost went over himself, you wanted to see. She wanted to see the propellers. Like I said, women and machinery do not mix. Was that the way of it? Yeah. That was pretty much it. Well, the boy's a hero then. Good for you, son. Well done. So it's all well. And back to our brandier. Look at you, you must be freezing. Let's get you inside, perhaps a little something for the boy. Of course, Mr. Lovejoy, I think a 20 should do it. Is that the going rate for saving women you love? Rose is displeased. What to do? I know. Perhaps you could join us for dinner tomorrow evening to regale our group with your heroic tale. Sure, count me in. Good, settled then. This should be interesting. Can I burn a smoke? You'll want to tie those. It's interesting. The young lady slipped so suddenly. And you still had time to remove your jacket and your shoes. I know you've been melancholy. I don't pretend to know why I intended to save this until the engagement gala next week. But I thought tonight, good gracious, perhaps is a reminder of my feelings for you. Is it a diamond? Yes, it was worn by Louis or something, and they called it Le Coeur de la Mer. The heart of the ocean? Yes, it's overwhelming. Well, it's for royalty. We are royalty, Rose. You know there's nothing I can give you. There's nothing I deny you. If you would not deny me, now open your heart to me, Rose. Well, I've been on my own since I was 15, since my folks died, and I had no brothers or sisters or close kin in that part of the country, so I lit out of here. And since I haven't been back since, you could just call me a tumbleweed blowing in the wind. Well, Rose, we've walked about a mile. Around this boat. And chewed over how great the weather's been and how I grew up. But I reckon that's not why you came to talk to me, is it? Mr. Dawson, I, Jack. Jack, I want to thank you for what you did. Not just for pulling me back, but for your discretion. You're welcome. Look, I know what you must be thinking. Poor little rich girl, what does she know about misery? No, that's not what I was thinking. What I was thinking was, what could have happened to this girl to make her think she had no way out? Well, it was everything. It was my whole world and all the people in it. And the inertia of my life plunging ahead. And me powerless to stop it. God, look at that thing. You should have gone straight to the bottom. All of Philadelphia society will be there. And all the while, I feel I'm standing in the middle of a crowded room. Screaming at the top of my lungs, and no one even looks up. Do you love him? Pardon me, do you love him? You're being very rude. You shouldn't be asking me this. Well, it's a simple question. Do you love the guy or not? This is not a suitable conversation. Why can't you just answer the question? This is absurd. You don't know me, and I don't know you. We are not having this conversation at all. You are rude and uncouth. And presumptuous. Am I? I'm leaving now. Jack, Mr. Dawson, It's been a pleasure. I sought you out to thank you. And now... I have thanked you, and you've insulted me. Well, you deserved it. Right, right, I thought you were leaving. I am, you are so annoying. Wait, I don't have to leave. This is my part of the ship. You'll leave. Oh, ho, ho, ho. Well, 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 now who's being rude? What is the stupid thing you're carrying around? So what are you? An artist or something? Well, these are rather good. They're very good, actually. Jack, this is exquisite work. They don't seem too much of them in old Paris. You do get around for a poor, well, a person of limited means. Go on, a poor guy. You can say it. Well, well, well. And these were drawn from life. Well, that's one of the things about Paris. Lots of girls willing to get painted. You like this woman you saw, used her several times. She had beautiful hands, you see. I think you must have had a love affair with her. No, 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 she just with her hands. She was a one-legged person. See, oh, she had a good sense of humor, though. Oh, and this lady, she used to sit at this bar with every night, wearing every piece of jewelry she owned. Just waiting for her long-lost love, calling her Madame Bijou. See how her clothes are all moth-eaten. Well, you have a gift, Jack. You do, you see, people. I see you, and you wouldn't have jumped, but the purpose of university is to find a suitable husband. Rose has already done that. Look, here comes that vulgar brown woman. Quickly get up before she sits with us. Hello, girls. I was hoping I'd catch you at tea. We're awfully sorry you missed it. The Countess and I were just off to take the air on the boat deck. What a lovely idea. I need to catch up on my gossip. Countess, so you've not yet lit the last four boilers. No, I don't see the need. We are making excellent time. The press knows the size of Titanic. Now I want them to marvel at our speed. We must give them something new to print. This maiden voyage of Titanic must make headlines. Mr. Ismay, I would prefer not to push the engines until they've been properly run in. Of course, I'm just a passenger. I leave it to your good offices to decide what's best. But what a glorious end to your final crossing. If we were to get into New York on Tuesday night and surprise them all, make the morning papers retire with a bang, eh? Good man, well, after that, I worked on a squid boat in Monterey. Then I went down to Los Angeles to the pier in Santa Monica and started doing portraits there, 14 cents a piece. Why can't I be like you, Jack? Just head out for the horizon whenever I feel like it. Say, we'll go there sometime to the pier. Even if we only ever just talk about it. No, we'll do it. We'll drink cheap beer. We'll ride on the roller coaster till we throw up. Then we'll ride horses on the beach, right in the surf. But you'll have nothing to do it like a real cowboy. None of that side saddle stuff. You mean one leg on each side? Yeah, can you show me? Sure, if you like. Teach me to ride like a man and chew tobacco like a man. And spit like a man. They didn't teach you that in finishing school, no. Well, come on, I'll show you. Let's do it. I'll show you how. Come on, Jack. No, Jack, no. Wait, Jack. No, Jack. I couldn't possibly, Jack. Watch closely. That's disgusting. All right. Your turn. That was pitiful. Come on, you really gotta hawk it back, you know. Get some leverage to it. Use your arms. Arc your neck. See the range on that thing. Mm-hmm. Okay, go. That was better. You got to work on it. Really? Really try and hawk it up. And get some body to it, you know? You got to. Mother? May I introduce Jack Dawson? Charmed, I'm sure. The others were gracious and curious about the man who had saved my life. But my mother looked at him like an insect. A dangerous insect, which must be squashed quickly. Well, Jack, sounds like you're a good man to have around in a sticky spot. Why do they always insist on announcing dinner like a darn cavalry charge? Shall we go to dress, Mother? See you at dinner, Jack. Son, do you have the slightest comprehension what you're doing? Not really. Well, you're about to go into the snake pit. What are you planning to wear? I figured, come on, I was right. You and my son are just about the same size. Pretty close. You shine up like a new penny. Good evening, sir. Good evening. Hello. Do you know that there are several thousand tons of Hockley steel in this very ship? Which part? All the right ones, of course. Then we'll know who to hold accountable. If there's a problem, where's my daughter? Oh, she'll be along. There in the countess. Hello, my dear. Good evening, Cal. So good to see you. I saw that in a Nickelodeon once, and I always wanted to do it. I'll see you at dinner, darling, surely. You remember Mr. Dawson? Well, it's amazing you could almost pass for a gentleman. Almost extraordinary. My dear, it's delightful to see you. What a remarkable voyage. This is, it's mad, isn't it? I love your perfume. There's the Countess of Rhodes. And there's John Jacob Astor. He's the richest man on the ship. His little wifey there, Madeline, is my age. And in delicate condition. See how she's trying to hide it, quite the scandal. And that's Benjamin Guggenheim and his mistress, Madame Albert. Mrs. Guggenheim is at home with the children, of course. And over here we have Sir Cosmo and Lucio Lady. Duff Gordon, she designs naughty lingerie and among her many talents. Very popular with the royals, congratulations, Hockley. She's splendid, why thank you. Care to escort a lady to dinner? Certainly, sweet pea, sweet pea. Ain't nothing to it. Is there Jack? Remember, they love money, so just pretend like you own a gold mine, and you're in the club. Hey, Astor, well, hello, Molly, nice to see you. JJ, Madeline, I'd like you to meet Jack Dawson. How'd you do? Pleasure, hello, Jack. Are you of the Boston Dawsons? No, the Chippewa Falls Dawsons, actually. Oh, yes, yes. He must have been nervous, but then never faltered. They assumed he was one of them. Heir to a railroad fortune, perhaps. New money, obviously, but still of a member of the club. My mother, of course, could always be counted upon. Tell us of the accommodations in steerage, Mr. Dawson. I hear they're quite good. On this ship, the best I've seen, ma'am, hardly any rats. Mr. Dawson is joining us from the third class. He was of some assistance to my fiancé last night. Turns out that Mr. Dawson is quite a fine artist. He was kind enough to show me some of his work today. Rose and I differ somewhat in our definition of fine art. Not to impugn your work, sir. She may be mine on paper, but in the eyes of God, she belongs to Thomas Andrews. Are all these four for me? Just stare from the outside and work your way in, he knows. Every rivet in her, don't you, Thomas? Your ship is a wonder, truly. Thank you, Rose. And how do you take your caviar? Sir, no caviar for me, thanks. Never did like it much. And where exactly do you live? Mr. Dawson, well, right now, my address is the RMS. Titanic after that. I'm on God's good humor. And how is it? You have means to travel. I work my way. From place to place. You know, tramp steamers and such. But I won my ticket on Titanic here. At a lucky hand at poker. A very lucky hand. All life is a game of luck, a real man makes his own luck, Archie Wright Dawson. And you find that sort of ruthless existence appealing, do you? Well, yes, ma'am, I do, I mean. Got everything I need right here with me. Got air in my lungs and a few blank sheets of paper. I mean, I love waking up in the morning not knowing what's going to happen or who I'm going to meet. where I'm going to wind up. Just the other night I was sleeping under a bridge, and now here I am. And the grandest ship in the world having champagne. With you fine people, I'll have some more of that. I figure life's a gift, and I don't intend on wasting it. You never know what hand you're going to get dealt with next. You learn to take life as it comes to you. Here you go, Cal, to make each day count. Well, it said Jack, hear, hear, to making it count, to making it count. Bravo, Mr. Brown, had no idea I'd hidden the money in the stove, so he comes home, drunk as a pig. Celebrating and he lights a fire. Next it'll be brandies in the smoking room. Well, join me in a brandy, gentleman. Now they retreat into a cloud of smoke and congratulate each other on being masters of the universe. Ladies, thank you for the pleasure of your company. Rose, may I escort you back to the cabin? No, I'll stay here. Here you go, Molly, joining us, Dawson. You don't want to stay out here with the women, do you? No, thanks. I've got to be heading back. Probably best. It'll be all business and politics, that sort of thing. Wouldn't interest you. But Dawson, good of you to come. Jack, must you go? Time for me to go row with the other slaves. Good night, Rose. So you want to go to a real party? Is okay. I put my hand here. Okay. Tala frickin' Svenza. What? I can't understand you. Hey, bravo. Bravo. Thank you. Come on, guys. Let's go. I'm going to dance with her now. All right. Oh, come on. What? Come with me. What? Jack, wait. I can't do this. I'm going to have to get a little bit closer. Like this. You're still my best girl, Cora. I don't know the steps. Neither do I. Just go with it. Don't think, hey, wait. Jack, wait, stop, Jack. Ba, ba, ba. Wait, hey, Jano. What jurisdiction of the Sherman Act? So my lawyers will argue that's what Rockefeller said. But the Supreme Court is not swallowing it. What do you think a first-class girl can't drink? Get out of here, you all right, I'm fine. 2 out of 3, 2 out of 3, so You think you're a big tough man? Let's see you do this, hold this for me. Jack hold it up, oh Jesus, Mary Joseph. You alright? I haven't done that in years. Go see Maggie, let's give her the holly. Let's go, ho, coffee, sir. I had hoped you would come to see me last night. I was tired. Your exertions below decks were no doubt exhausting. I see you had that undertaker of a manservant follow me. How typical. You will never behave like that again, Rose. Ooh. Do you understand? I'm not a foreman in the one of your mills that you command. I'm your fiancé, my fiancé. My fiancé, yes you are, and my wife. My wife, in practice, is not yet by law, so you will honor me. You will honor me the way a wife is required to honor a husband, because I will not be made out of fool, Rose, in this, in any way, unclear, no good. Excuse me, Miss Rose. We had a little accident. That's all right, Miss Rose. That's all right.
I'm sorry, Trudy. Let me help you. It's all right, Miss. It's all right, Miss. T. Trudy. Yes, ma'am. You're not to see that boy again. Do you understand me?
Rose, I forbid it. Oh, stop it, Mother. You'll give yourself a nosebleed. This is not a game.
Our situation is precarious.
You know, the money's gone.
Of course, I know it's gone.
You remind me every day. Your father left us nothing but a legacy of bad debts hidden by a good name. That name is the only card we have to play. I don't understand you. It is a fine match with Hockley. It will ensure our survival. How can you put this on my shoulders? Why are you being so selfish? I'm being selfish. Do you want to see me working as a seamstress? Is that what you want to see? Our fine things sold at auction, our memories scattered to the winds. It's so unfair. Yeah, of course it's unfair. We're women. Oh, our choices are never easy. Protect them by the guardian hand from every peril of the land, O spirit whom the Father sent to spread across the ferment. O wind of heaven, by thy might, save all who dare. The eagles fly and keep them by thy watchful. Hello, Mr. Andrews. Hello, Jack. Sir, I need to talk to somebody for a sec. You're not supposed to be in here. Fire and foe, protect them. I was just here last night. You don't remember me? No, I'm afraid I don't. Now you're going to have to turn around. He'll just tell you. I just need Mr. Hockley. And Mrs. DeWitt Buckletter, continue to be appreciative of your assistance. They asked me to give you this in gratitude. I don't want your money, please. I also to remind you that you hold a third class ticket and that your presence here is no longer appropriate. Please, I just want to speak to Rose Four. Gentlemen, will you please see that Mr. Dawson gets to where he belongs and that he stays there? Yes, sir, come along. You owe here us. When we cry to thee for those in peril on the sea, and why do you have two steering wheels? We really only use this near shore. Excuse me, sir. Another ice warning. This one's for the norm, damn. Thank you, Sparks, so not to worry. Quite normal for this time of year. In fact, we're speeding up. I've just ordered the last boilers lit. Okay, son. Wind it up tight like I showed you. Okay, now let it go. Was nice, wasn't it? Quite nice. That's excellent, son. Mr. Andrews, forgive me. I did the sum in my head and with the numbers of life. Both times the capacity you mentioned, forgive me. But it seems that there are not enough for everybody aboard. About half, actually. Rose, you missed nothing, do you? In fact, I put in these new type divots, which can take an extra row of boats inside this one. But it was thought by some that the deck would look too cluttered, so I was overruled, waste of deck space. As it is on an unsinkable ship. Sleep soundly, young Rose. I have built you a good ship. Strong and true. She's all. The lifeboat you need, just keep heading aft. The next stop will be the engine room. Come on, Jack. This is impossible. I can't see you. I need to talk to you. No, Jack, I'm engaged. I'm marrying Cal. I love Cal. Rose, you're no picnic, alright. You're a spoiled little brat, even, but under that. You're the most amazingly astounding, wonderful girl, woman. That I've ever known, and Jack, I. No, let me try and get this out. You're May. I'm not an idiot. I know how the world works. I've got $10 in my pocket. I have nothing to offer you. And I know that. I understand. But I'm too involved now. You jump, I jump, remember. I can't turn away without knowing you'll be alright. That's all I want. Well, I'm fine, I'll be fine, really. Really, I don't think so. They've got you trapped, Rose, and you're going to die. If you don't break free, maybe not right away, because you're strong, but sooner or later that fire I love about you, Rose, that fire is going to burn out. It's not to you to save me, Jack. You're right. Only you can do that. I'm going back. Leave me alone. Tell Lucille about the disaster you had with the stationers. Well, of course, the invitations had to be sent back twice. Oh, my dear, and the dreadful bridesmaid's gowns. Let me tell you what not to see that had been. Rose decided she wanted lavender, she knows. I detest the color, so she did it only to spite me. If only you'd come to me sooner. Ruth saw some of my designs in La Mode Illustrée. There were four, Trousseau and one of the Duchess of Marlborough's youngest daughter. They were quite charming, but I think you'll agree, my dear, that we've created something of a phoenix from the ashes. Hello, Jack. I changed my mind. They said you might be shh. Give me your hand. Now close your eyes. Go on. Step up. Now hold on to the railing. Keep your eyes closed. Don't peek. I'm not. Step up onto the rail. Hold on, hold on. Keep your eyes closed. Do you trust me? I trust you. All right, open your eyes. I'm flying, Jack. Come, Josephine. My flying machine going up. She goes. Up there she goes. That was the last time Titanic ever saw daylight. So we're up to dusk, the night of the sinking, 6 hours to go, incredible. There's Smith and he's standing there, and he's got the iceberg warming in his effing hand. Excuse me, his hand, and he's ordering more speed. Working against him, he figures anything big enough to sink the ship they're going to see in time to turn, but the ship's too big with too small a rudder. Doesn't corner worth a darn. Everything he knows is wrong. It's quite proper, I assure you. This is the sitting room. Will this light do? Don't artists need good light? That is true, but I'm not used to working in such horrible conditions. Manetta, do you know his work? Of course, look at his use of color here. Isn't he great? I know, he's extraordinary. Cal insists on carting this hideous thing everywhere. Should we be expecting him anytime soon? Not as long as the cigars and brandy hold out. That's nice. What is it, a sapphire? A diamond. A very rare diamond. Jack, I want you to draw me like one of your French girls wearing this. Alright, wearing only this. The last thing I need is another picture of me looking like a porcelain doll. As a paying customer, I expect to get what I want. Over the, on the bed, on the couch. Go lie down, tell me when it looks right. Put your arm back the way it was right. Put that other arm up, that hand right by your face there. Right now, head down, eyes to me, keep them on me. And try to stay still, so serious I believe. You are blushing, Mr. Big Artsy. I can't imagine Monsieur Monette blushing. He does landscapes. Just relax your face. Sorry, no laughing. My heart was pounding the whole time. It was the most erotic moment of my life. Up until then, at least. So what happened next? You mean, did we do it? Sorry to disappoint you. Mr. Bodine, Jack was a very professional. Thank you. What are you doing? Will you put this bag in the safe for me? Would you excuse me? None of these stewards have seen her. This is absurd. It's a ship. There's only so many places. She could be Lovejoy, find her clear. Yes, I don't think I've ever seen such a flat calm. Like a mill pond, not a breath of wind. It will make the bergs harder to see, with no breaking water at the base. Well, I'm off, maintain speed, and heading Mr. Light Roller. Yes, sir, it's getting cold, you look nice, Miss Rose. My drawings, come on. No, wait, go, down, quickly, bye, sorry. It's alright, pretty tough for valet. This fellow seems more like a cop. I think he was, oh poop. No, over here, quick. Now what, hold up, what are you two doing down here? You shouldn't be down here, it could be dangerous. Carry on, don't mind us. You're doing a great job. Keep up the good work. Look what we have here, huh? Thank you. Where to, miss? To the stars. You nervous? No. Put your hands on me, Jack. God, it's bloody cold. You know I can smell ice, you know. When it's near, bollocks. But I can, alright. Did you ever find those binoculars for the lookouts? Haven't seen them since Southampton. Well, I'll be on my rounds. Cheerio, you're trembling. Don't worry. I'll be alright. They ran down there. Right, anything missing? I've got a better idea. Gotcha. Did you see those guys' faces? Did you see the when the ship docks? I'm getting off with you. This is crazy, I know. It doesn't make any sense. That's why I trusted, oh yes. Here, look at you. Oh, look at that, wouldn't you? You're a bit warmer than we are. Well, if that's what it takes for us to get warmer, I'd rather not, if it's all the same to you. Bugger me, pick up you bastards. Isn't there anyone there? Yes, what do you see? Iceberg right ahead. Thank you, iceberg right ahead. Hard to starboard. Hard to starboard. Turn up steady. Full last turn. Hard over helms, hard over sir. Go lads, go. Shut the dampers, shut them. Hold it now engaged. The reversing engine, why aren't they turning? Is it hard over? It is, sir, yes, sir. It's hard over. Come on, come on, come on. Turn, yes. It's going to hit. Jesus Christ, Jesus, hard to port. Crew, hard to port. Get back. Come on, let's go. Get out the door. They're closing the doors. Get out, get out, get out, get out. Get out the door. Go on, go on. Come on, lads. Go, lads, go. Get out. Oh my God. That was a close shave, weren't it? Smell ice, can you? Bleeding Christ, note the time. And enter it in the log. What was that? Mr. Murdoch, an iceberg, sir. I put her hard to starboard and ran. The engine's full astern, but it was too close. I tried to port round it, but she hit and closed the watertight doors. The doors are closed, sir. I'll stop. Aye, sir. Find the carpenter, get him to sound the ship. Yes, sir. Porca puta noche, chaco so it. Come on. Let's get the heck out of here. Come on, hurry up. Excuse me. Why have the engine stopped? I felt a shudder. I shouldn't worry, madam. We most likely thrown a propeller blade. That's the shudder you felt. May I bring you anything? No, thank you. Did you see anything? I don't see anything now. Do you? This is the direction the rats are going. That's good enough for me. Please, sir, please, everything's under control. You there, sir, there's no emergency. Yes, there is. I have been robbed. Get the master at arms. Now, you moron. Yes, sir. Hey, you're going to miss the fun. Did you see what happened? No, I missed it. Apparently, it hit over there. Boil room 6 is flooded 8 feet above the plate. And the moil hold is worse. She's all buckled in the forward hold. Can you shore up? Not unless the pumps get ahead. Have you seen the damage in the mail hold? No, she's already underwater. This is bad. We should tell Mother and Cal. I think they're very good, sir. Don't touch anything. I want the entire room photographed. Just keep holding my hand. We've been looking for you, miss. Well, here we go. Something serious has happened. Yes, it has. Indeed, 2 things to me have disappeared this evening. Now that one is back, I have a pretty good idea where to find the other. Search him. Take your coat off, sir. Now what? Come on, Cal. What are you doing? We're in the middle of an emergency. What's going on? Is this it? That's it. This is horse poop. Don't you believe it, Rose? Don't. He couldn't have. Of course he could. It's easy enough for a professional, but I was with him the whole time. This is absurd. Perhaps he did it while you were putting your clothes back on, dear. Real slick cow rose they put in my pocket. Shut up. Isn't even your pocket, is it, son? Property of A.L. Ryerson. That was reported stolen today. I just borrowed it. I was going to return it. We have an honest thief here, do we? You know I didn't do it, Rose. You know it. You didn't believe them, Rose. You know I didn't do it. Come on, let's go. You know I didn't do it, Rose, Rose. Come on, son. There's a good lad. Come on, you know I didn't do it. You know me. Most unfortunate captain. Water 14 feet above the keel in 10 minutes. In the fore peak, in all 3 holds, and in the boiler room 6. That's right, sir. When can we get underway? Darn it. That's 5 compartments. She can stay afloat with the first 4 compartments breached. But not 5, not 5. As she goes down by the head, the water will spill over the tops of bulkheads at E deck from 1 to the next. Back and back, there's no stopping it, the pumps. If we open the doors, the pumps buy you time. But all minutes only. From this moment, no matter what we do, Titanic will founder, but this ship can't sink. She's made of iron, sir. I assure you she can, and she will. It is a mathematical certainty. How much time? An hour, 2 at most. And how many aboard? Mr. Modoc? Well, I believe you may get your headlines, Mr. Ismay. Oh. Will you look at me when I'm talking to you? Mr. Hockley, not now, we're busy. Sir, I've been told you to ask you to please put on your life belt and come up to. I said not now. I'm sorry to inconvenience you, Mr. Hockley, but it's captain's orders. Now please, dress warmly. It's quite cold out tonight. Now may I suggest top coats and hats? This is ridiculous. Not to worry, miss. I am sure it's just a precaution. Everybody up. Life belts on. What's he yelling about? Everybody up. Put your life belts on. What's the ruckus? Just put your life belts on. CQ-do. That's right. CQ-do. The distress call. That's our position. Tell whoever responds that we're going down by the head. We need immediate assistance. Blimey, keep lowering. Deep lowering, Mr. Wild, Mr. Wild. Where are the passengers? We moved them back inside. It's too darn cold and noisy for them. You there? Get down here and help with these lines. Care for a drink, sir? Please put your life belts on. Hey, Sonny, what's doing? You got us all trussled up here. And now we're cooling our heels. Sorry, ma'am. Let me go and find out. I don't think anybody knows what the heck's going on around here. It's the gosh darn English doing everything by the book. There's no need for language, Mr. Hockley. Go back and turn the heaters on in our rooms. I'd like a cup of tea when I return. Yes, ma'am. Mr. Andrews, I saw the iceberg and I see it in your eyes. Please tell me the truth, your ship will sink. You're certain, yes, an hour or so, and all this will be at the bottom of the Atlantic. What, please tell me only who you must. I don't want to be responsible for a panic. And get to a boat quickly. Don't wait, you remember what I told you about the boats? Yes, I understand. Over here, sir. Sir, they need you. Up in the second class purser's office. There's a big mob up there. Go on. I'll keep an eye on him. All right. Yes, sir. Carpathia says they're making 17 knots. Full steam for them, sir. She's the only one responding. The only one close, sir. She says they can be here in 4 hours. 4 hours. Thank you, bride. My gosh. Sir, we are swung out and ready, sir, and we better get the women and children onto the boat, sir. Yes, we do, sir. Women and children first. Yes, sir. Ladies and gentlemen, your attention, please. Step this way. Please. That's right. Come towards me. Thank you, good, for the time. Being I shall require only women and children. Right here, all right, boys, like the captain said. Nice and cheery, so there's no panic. Wedding dance, life belts on. Here, put your life belts on. Put your life belts on here. Put your life belts on. Put your life belts on here. Put your life belts on here. Come on here. It isn't time to go up to the boats yet. Please stay calm. Look, please make sure everybody you've got your life belts on. And gentlemen, allow the women and children through to the front. What are we doing, mommy? We're just waiting, dear. When they're finished putting the first class people in the boats, they'll start with us, and we'll want to be ready, won't we? Go and get some help. Lower way, left and right together. Steady, both sides together. Steady, steady. Steady, stop it. Stop, hold the left side, right side only. Right side only. Hold the left side, right side down. Lower way together. Steady, lads. You know, I do believe this ship may sink. I've been asked to give you this small token of our appreciation. Compliments of Mr. Calden Hockley. Come on, sister, you heard the man. Into the boat. Any room for a gentleman? Gentlemen, only women at this time, sir. Will the lifeboats be seated according to class? I hope they're not too crowded. Oh, mother, shut up. Don't you understand? The water's freezing. And there aren't enough boats, not enough by half. Half the people on this ship are going to die, not the better half. Come on, Ruth, get in the boat. First class seats are right up here. I know it's a pity I didn't keep that drawing. It'll be worth a lot more by morning. You unimaginable person. Come on, Rose, darling. There's plenty of room for you. Come on, Rose. You're next, darling. Come into the boat, Rose. Come, Rose. Get into the boat, Rose. Goodbye, Mother. Rose, Rose, we'll come back here. Where are you going? To him to be. To a gutter rat, I'd rather be a his than your wife. No, no, I said no. Rose, please stop and lower away. Rose, man the tiller. No, wait, lower away. Rose, lower together. Help. Can anybody hear me? Hello. Help me, help me. Can anybody hear me? Somebody help me, please. Rose, Mr. Andrews. Steward, check the starboard corridor. Yes, Mr. Andrews. Madam, please put on a lifebelt. Get to the boat deck immediately. Lucy, for gosh sake, put on your lifebelt. Set a good example. Yes, sir, anyone in here? Mr. Andrews, thank gosh. Where would the master at arms take someone under arrest? What, you have to get to a boat right away? No, I'm going to do this with or without your help, sir, but without will take longer. Take the elevator to the bottom. Go to the left down the crewman's passage, then go right and left again. At the stairs, you'll come to a long corridor. This could be bad. Oh, poop, oh, poop. Excuse me, thank you. The lifts are closed, I do not care. The lifts are, sorry, miss, but the lifts are closed. I'm being polite, gosh darn it. Now take me down, E-deck, come on, I'm going back up. No, no, no. Come back, I'm going back up, I'm going back up. Crew passage, Jack, Rose, I'm in here, Jack, I'm in here, Rose, Jack, I'm sorry. That guy loved joy, put it in my pocket, I know. Listen, Rose, you're going to have to find a spare key, alright? Look in that cabinet right there. It's a little silver one, Rose, silver. These are all brass ones, check. Right here, Rose, how'd you find out? I didn't do it. I didn't. I just realized I already knew. Keep looking. Oh, no key. There's no key. All right, Rose, listen, you're gonna have to go find some help. It'll be all right. I'll be right back. I'll just wait here. Hello. Is there anyone here? Hello, is there anybody down here? We need help, help, hello. Darn it, can anybody hear me? Please, hello, hello, oh, thank you. Wait, please, I need your help. There's a man back here, and wait, hello, hello. I miss you, shouldn't be here now. Please, I need your help this way. Quickly, there's a man down here, and he is trapped, please. There's no need to panic. I'm not panicking. You're going the wrong way. Let go of me. Listen. To heck with you. Oh my God. Jack, Rose, will this work? I guess we'll find out. Come on. Wait a couple. Try a couple swings over there. All right. Good. Now try to hit the same mark again. Rose, you can do it. Okay, that's enough practice. Come on, Rose. You can do it. Listen. Just hit it real hard and really fast. Wait, open your hands up a little more. Like that, Rose. Listen, Rose, I trust you. Go. You did it. Come on, let's go. Oh, poop, this is cold. This is the way out. We have to find another way. Come on, pull, pull, put your backs into it. Pull, pull. Now there's something you don't see every day. Pull, what's this luggage doing here? Get rid of it. We need the room. Keep calm, no, Lovejoy, she's not on the starboard side either. We're running out of time, and this strutting martinet isn't letting any men on at all. There's one on the other side letting men on. Well, then that's our play. We'll need some insurance first. Come on this way. All the way down here, here. What do you think you're doing? You'll have to pay for that. You know that's White Star Line property. Shut up. Will you hold the boat any moment? I just have to run back to my room. Sit down. She's the last. All right, to lower. Mr. Light Roller, why are the boats being launched? Half full, not now. Mr. Andrews, look, there's 20 or so in a boat, built for 65. Well, I saw one boat with only 12. Well, we weren't sure of the weight, Mr. Andrews. These boats may buckle rubbish. They were tested in Belfast with a weight of 70 men. Now fill these boats, Mr. Light Roller, for God's sake, man, please. I need more women, children, please. Crewmen, get back in there. This is not an exit. Get back in there. This is not an exit. You can't keep us locked in here like animals. This ship's bloody sinking. Bring forward the women. Unlock the gates, women only, no men. Get back, lock the gates. For God's sake, man, there are women and children down here. Let us up so we can have a chance. Get back. Jack, Tommy. Can we get out? It's hopeless that way. Whatever we do, we've got it to do it fast. Jack? Fabrizio! The boats are all gone. This whole place is flooding. There is 9-10 this way. All right, let's go. This way. All right, come on. I'll make my own luck. So do I. Come on, no. Come on, let's go this way. This way, just go back to the main stairwell. And everything will be sorted out there. Heck, it will. It will all get sorted out back there. Go back to the main stairwell. Open the gate. Go back to the main stair. Open the gate right now. Go back to the main stair, like I told you. Gosh darn it, son of a bleep. Stop that. Open the door gate. Open it. Fabri, Tommy, give me a hand here. Move aside, move aside. Come on, pull, pull. Move aside. Pull that down. Move aside. 1, 2. Stop that. 3. Again, let's go. Let's go, Rose. You can't do this up here. You can't do this. Keep back, back, back. Hold on to her. Pull her in. Get back, I say. Or I'll shoot you like all dogs. Keep order here. Keep order, I say. Mr. Lowman, this boat. Right, is everybody all right? Nobody panic. Stay back. We're too late. There are more boats down the front. Stay this one, Murdoch. He seems to be quite practical. Sit down. Stay back, you lot. Stay back. Stay back. The lot of you stay back. It's starting to fall apart. We don't have much time. Murdoch. Mr. Hockley, you too, with me. I'm a businessman, as you know, and I have a business proposition for you. Easy now, all together, lower way, lower way. Come on, Rose, the boats are gone. Colonel, are there any boats on that side? No, miss, but there are a couple of boats all the way for you, Ord. This way I'll lead you. What's the use? Nobody's listening to us anyway. Well, they don't listen to us at dinner either. Come on, let's play. Keep us warm. Orpheus, music to drown by. Now I know. I'm in first class. Where is everyone? They're all still left, sir. We have an understanding then. Mr. Murdo, women and children only, get back. Step back. Come, sir, come through, madam. This way, step back, sir. You better check the other side, go. Any more women and children? Any children? I found her on the other side, waiting for a boat with him. Any more women and children? They're all aboard, Mr. Murdo. anyone else than anyone else. Hurry along, stand by the falls. Oh gosh darn it all, to poop fire. Sir, you can't go through here, sir, you can't go through here, yes, splendid. Right, prepare to lower. Ready on the left, take them down. Keep it steady, both sides together. Steady, keep it steady. Give here to me, daddy. It'll be fine, darling. Don't you worry, it's goodbye. For a little while, only for a little while. There'll be another boat for the daddies. This boat's for the mummies and the children. You hold mummy's hand and be a good little girl. I'm not going. Without you, no, you have to go now. No, Jack, get in the boat, Rose. No, Jack, yes, get on the boat. Yes, get on the boat, Rose. My God, look at you. You look a fright here. Put this on. Come on, go on. I'll get the next one. No, not without you. I'll be all right. Listen, I'll be fine. I'm a survivor, all right. Don't worry about me. Now go on. Get on. I have an arrangement with an officer on the other side of the ship. Jack and I can get off safely, both of us. See, got my own boat to catch. Now hurry, they're almost full. Step aboard, miss. Come on, hurry, step aboard, please. Be daddy's good girl. Step lively, keep back, I say. Clear the row, please, lower away. Slowly, keep going. And lower away evenly. Lads, easy, lower away, you're a good liar, almost as good as you. Easy now, and lower away, there's no arrangement, is there? No, there is. Not that you'll benefit much from it, I always win, Jack, one way or another. Easy, even, lads, keep going. Rose, stop her. Rose, what are you doing? Stop her. No, Rose, you're so stupid. Why'd you do that? You're so stupid, Rose. Why'd you do that? Why you jump? I jump. Right. Oh, God, I couldn't go. I couldn't go, Jack. It's all right. We'll think of something else. At least I'm with you. We'll think of something. Come on, move, Rose, come on, Rose, come on, move, Rose, go. I hope you enjoy your time together. What could possibly be funny? I put the diamond in the coat, and I put the coat on her. Come on, we can't leave him. All right, come on, go back. It's the wrong way. Come back. Go. Jack, Rose, this way. Come on, give me your hand. Oh God, help. Rose, help. Wait, sir, open the gate. Please help us. Please, bloody heck. Come on. Go. Jesus, please come on, hurry. Come on, I'm sorry, I dropped the keys, wait please, don't leave please, don't leave, please, get more help, no, which one is it, Rose? The sharp one. Try the sharp one. Hurry, Jack. Oh, no. Hurry, Jack. It's stuck. Hurry, it's stuck. Hurry, Jack. Hurry, I got it. I got it. Go, go, Rose. Go, go, Jack, Jack. Come on, move, move. Keep on rocking. Oars in place. Getting oar under it. Women, children only. Darn you. Hold it, hold it. Get these davits cranked in then. Get the falls hooked up. Stay back. Help me keep going up. Stop pushing. Stay back. Will you give us a chance to live? You lie me, person. I'll shoot any man who tries to get past me. Get back, person. Get back. We had a deal, darn you. Your money can't save you anymore. Then it could save me. Get back. Women and children only. Tommy, no Tommy. Oh no, 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 no Tommy, no Will. Stand back, darn you. Get back, darn you. I have a child, I have a child. Clear path here, I have a child. Please, I'm all she has. In the world, go on, step back, please. Step back, I say, please. Here, give her to me, give her here. There, there. Wait, 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 Mr. Andrews or Rose. Won't you even make a try for it? I'm sorry, I didn't build you a stronger ship, young Rose. It's going fast. We have to move. Wait. Good luck to you, Rose, and to you, Mr. Guggenheim. These are for you, Mr. Guggenheim. No, thank you. We are dressed in our best and prepared to go down as gentlemen. But we would like a brandy. Captain, Captain, where should I go, please? Captain, Captain, sir. Right, that's it then. Goodbye, Wally, good luck. So long, old chap. So they lived happily together for 300 years in the land of Tyr, Nanog, the land of eternal youth and beauty. There's no time, cut those falls. Cut them if you have to. I need a knife, I need a knife. Cut her loose. Cut those bloody falls. Gentlemen, it has been a privilege playing with you tonight. We have to stay on the ship as long as possible. Come on, this wee over the rail. Come on, jump, come on. I got you, jump, I've got you, miss. Jack, Jack, come on, get back. No, you'll swamp us. Yeah, through, I walk through the valley of the shadow of death. You want to walk a little faster through that valley there. Row, pull together. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for our sinners now and at the hour of our death, amen. Hail Mary, full of grace. The Lord is with thee this way. Jack, come on, come on. I saw a new heaven and a new earth when the first heaven and the first earth had passed away and there was no more sea. Help me. And he shall dwell with them, and they shall be his people, and God himself shall be with them. Jack, this is where we first met, and God shall wipe his... away from the tears in their eyes, and there shall be no more death. Neither shall there be sorrow or crying. Bloody pull faster and pull. Hang on, Miss Trudy. Help me, please save me. Help, hold on real tight. Almighty, get those breakers and keep them. We have to move, give me your hand. I'll pull you over, I can't. Come on, give me your hand. I've got to, I won't let go, come on, I've got you. What's happening, Jack? I don't know, I don't know. Hold on, Jack. That was close. Help me, someone. Help me, please. One, two, three, This is it, oh god, hold on. Oh god, oh, the ship is going to suck us down. Take a deep breath when I say, kick for the surface and keep kicking. Do not let go of my hand, we're going to make it rose. Trust me, I trust you, ready, ready now. Jack, Jack, Jack. Jack, no. Swim, Rose, I need you to swim. Keep swimming, it's so cold. Swim, Rose, keep on. Here, keep swimming. Stay on it, Rose, stay on. Rose, Jack, you'll be alright. Now, you'll be alright. Return the boats. The boats are coming back for us, Rose. Hold on, just a little bit longer. Return the boats. They had to row away for the suction. But now, they'll be coming back. Come back, for God's sake, help, please. Come back. For God's sake, come back, for gosh sake. You don't understand. If we go back, they'll swamp the boat. They'll pull us down, I'm telling you. Knock it off. You're scaring me, come on, girls. Grab and or let's go. Are you out of your mind? We're in the middle of the North Atlantic. Now, do you want to live, or do you want to die? I don't understand a one of you. What's the matter with you? It's your men out there. There's plenty of room for more. And there'll be one less boat if you shut the hole in your face. Come back. Here, take this one. Now bring yours over there and tie these two boats together. And make sure that's tied up. Nice and tight, nice. Listen to me. I want to transfer all the women from this boat into that boat right now, as quick as you can. Please. Let's get some space there. Let's move forward and aft. It's getting quiet. It's just going to take them a couple minutes to get the boats organized. I don't know about you, but I intend to write a strongly worded letter to the White Star Line about all this. I love you, Jack. Don't you do that. Don't you say your goodbyes. Not yet. Do you understand me? I'm so cold. You're going to get out of here. You're going to go on, and you're going to make lots of babies. And you're going to watch them grow. You're going to die an old lady warm. In her bed, not here, not this night, not like this. Do you understand? Winning that ticket, Rose, was the best thing that ever happened to me. It brought me to you. And I'm thankful for that, Rose. I'm thankful. You must do me this honor. You must promise me that you'll survive. You won't give up, no matter what happens. Promise me now, Rose, and never let go of that promise. I promise, never let go. I will never let go, Jack. I'll never let go. Right ahead, sir. Oars, do you see any moving? No, sir, none of them moving. Check them. Check them, make sure. These are dead, sir. Now give away. Ahead easy. Careful with your oars. Don't hit them. Is there anyone alive out there? Can anyone hear me? We waited too long. We'll keep checking them. Keep looking. Is there anyone alive out there? And it's up she goes. Up she goes. Jack, there's a boat. There's a boat, Jack. Come back. Come back. Hello, can anyone hear me? There's nothing here. Come back. I'll never let go. I promise. Come about. When Titanic sank from under us, there were 20 boats floating nearby, and only one came back. Six were saved from the water, myself included. 6 out of 1,500. Afterwards, the 700 people in the boats had nothing to do but wait, wait to die, wait to live, wait for an absolution. that would never come. Oh, sir, I think you'll find any of your people down here. It's a steerage. His hair is reddish brown, and a white beard. Isn't there another passenger list? There's no other list. Perhaps he's on another ship. We're doing all we can, ma'am. There's got to be another list. That's the last time we ever saw him. He married, of course, and inherited his millions. But the crash of 29 hit his interests hard, and he put a pistol in his mouth that year, so I read. Can I take your name, please, love? Dawson, Rose Dawson, thank you. We never found anything on Jack. There's no record of him. No, there wouldn't be. Would there, and I've never spoke of him until now, not to anyone, not even your grandfather. A woman's heart is a deep ocean of secrets, but now you know there was a man named Jack Dawson, and he saved me in every way that a person can be saved. I don't even have a picture of him. He exists now only in my memory. Keldish, Keldish, Mir 2, on our way to surface. You know I was saving this when I found the diamond. I'm sorry, 3 years. I've thought of nothing except Titanic, but I never got it. I never let it in. Okay, and I'm done, because you've already heard my parody of My Heart Will Go On, so no more. This is done. I'm done.